students.
Now try to discuss about balancing of chemical equation. Chemical equation is condensed form of given chemical reaction. At the time of writing of chemical equation, this equation must be in balanced form. Now consider about what is difference between balanced equation and unbalanced equation. Consider reaction between silver nitrate AgNO3 plus sodium chloride NaCl. It gives AgCl plus NaNO3. Now this is chemical equation between reaction of silver nitrate with sodium chloride. When silver nitrate reacts with sodium chloride, it gives silver chloride and NaNO3. Now consider at first number of atoms of each element in reactant site. In reactant site there are two reactants, AgNO3 and NaCl. Here number of silver atoms is 1. Number of nitrogen atoms is also 1. Number of oxygen atoms, O, is 3. Number of sodium atoms is 1. Number of chlorine atom is also 1. It means that in reactant side, number of silver atoms 1, nitrogen atom 1, oxygen atom 3, sodium atom 1, chlorine atom 1. Now consider product side. At product side, silver atom, number of silver atom is 1. Number of nitrogen atom is 1. Number of oxygen atom 3. Number of sodium atom is 1. Number of chlorine atom is also 1. It means that here at reactant side, 1 silver atom. At product side, 1 silver atom. At reactant side, 1 nitrogen atom. At product side, there is 1 nitrogen atom. At reactant side, 3 oxygen atoms. At product side also, there are 3 oxygen atoms. At reactant side, there is 1 sodium atom. Product side also 1 sodium atom. At reactant side 1 chlorine atom. At product side 1 chlorine atom. It means that here number of atoms of each element in reactant side equals to number of each atom at each atom of every element at product. Hence, this equation is balanced equation. Now, consider reaction between hydrogen and oxygen. When hydrogen reacts with oxygen, water molecules are formed. Now, write equation of this reaction. H2 plus O2, it gives H2O. Now, at reactant side, there are two hydrogen atoms. At product side, there are two hydrogen atoms. At reactant side, there are two oxygen atoms. At product side, there is only one oxygen atom. It means that this reaction, this equation is unbalanced equation. From these two examples, difference between balanced equation and unbalanced equation is cleared one. Now, how chemical equation is balanced? When magnesium ribbon is burned in air or in presence of oxygen, it gives magnesium oxide. Now, at first, write word form of given reaction. Magnesium plus oxygen, it gives magnesium oxide. At first, write word form of given reaction. Now, write its chemical equation. Magnesium plus oxygen, it gives magnesium oxide. Now, try to balance the same equation. First, compare number of atoms of each element at reactant side and at product side. At reactant side, there is one magnesium atom. At product side, there is one magnesium atom. At reactant side, there are two oxygen atoms. At product side, there is only one oxygen atom. Means, number of oxygen atoms in reactant and products are not balanced one. So, to balance it, start from oxygen atoms. At reactant side, there are two oxygen atoms. At product side, there is one oxygen atom. Hence, multiply by two to magnesium oxide, that is Mg plus O2 multiplied by 2 MgO. Due to this, what happens here? Oxygen atoms are balanced, but at that time magnesium is unbalanced. In this case here, there is one magnesium at product set, there are two magnesium. So multiply Mg by 2 means 2 Mg plus O2 twice MgO, that is 2 Mg plus O2 it gives twice MgO. Now it is balanced chemical equation of given reaction. At last, write balanced chemical equation. Consider next example. Consider reaction between copper and sulfuric acid. When copper reacts with sulfuric acid, it gives copper sulfate plus water molecules plus sulfur dioxide. Copper, when reacts with sulfuric acid, it gives copper sulfate plus water molecules with evolution of sulfur dioxide gas. Here, at reactant side, there is one copper atom. At product side, copper is one. Hydrogen, two atoms. At product side, hydrogen, two atoms. At reactant side, there is one sulfur atom. At product side, one, two sulfur atoms. Here, four oxygen atoms. At this product side, 4 plus 1, 5 plus 2 means 7 oxygen atoms. Now this equation is unbalanced equation. So here, to balance this equation, start from H2SO4 molecule. Here Cu multiply it by 2 means Cu plus twice H2SO4. So here CuSO4 into 2 is 4 hydrogen atoms, here only 2 hydrogen atoms, so multiplying by also by 2 twice H2O plus SO2. Now at reactant side Cu1, at product side Cu1 atom. At reactant side, 2 into 2, 4 hydrogen atoms. At product side, 2 into 2, 4 hydrogen atoms. Means hydrogen is also balanced. Here, at reactant side, one sulfur atom. Here, S. Here, at reactant side, 2 into S means 2 sulfur atoms. How many atoms here? 2 sulfur atoms. Here, 1 plus 1. 2 sulfur atoms. Means sulfur is in balance. Oxygen atoms, 2 into 4. 8 oxygen atoms are present at reactant side. Here, 4 plus 2, 6 plus 2, 8. 8 oxygen atoms. Means, now this equation is balanced equation. So, write Cu plus twice H2SO4, it gives CuSO4 plus twice H2O plus SO2 upward displacement arrow. Now it is balanced chemical equation of reaction in between copper and sulfuric acid. In this way, by multiplying suitable number at reactant or product side, balancing of equation is possible one. Sometimes the equation is in balanced form, but that is invariable. Consider about reaction between sodium and chlorine to give sodium chloride. Here, one sodium atom at reactant side, one sodium atom at product side. One chlorine atom at reactant side, one chlorine atom at product side. Though number of atoms of each element at reactant and product side are same, equation is not valid. This equation is incorrect one, because chlorine is not in molecular form. Chemical equation is finally present in balanced form and also in molecular form. So, write this equation as sodium plus chlorine. It gives sodium chloride. Now, it is not balanced equation. Sodium 1, here sodium 1 atom. Chlorine 2 atoms, here chlorine 1 atoms. So, balancing, multiply sodium chloride by 2. Due to which we will get 2 chlorine atoms. That is sodium plus 4 chlorine, 2 NaCl. Now what happens here? Due to multiplying by 2, chlorine atoms are balanced. But imbalancing of sodium atom takes place. Here at product side there are two sodium atoms, at reactant side there is only one sodium atom, so multiply it by also 2. So 2 chlorine atoms. Now this is balanced chemical equation and it is also present in molecular form. So it is very very important that final chemical equation is in balanced form and also it must be in molecular.